Hi, I'm Travis, and I've used AdWords to build a multi-million dollar e-commerce business, and I've helped a lot of people do the same thing. So in this video, I wanted to share what I think are the five most powerful AdWords tips. So I'm gonna tell you all of them right now, and then the rest of this video, I'll go in depth and talk about each one of them. So number one is finding proper keywords, and I'll give some hints on how to do that. Number two is finding negative keywords, and this is a step a lot of people leave out, which just blows my mind, because if you forget this step, you're literally just wasting money. Number three is write powerful ad copy. You're spending the money on the clicks. You want to make sure that people are going to buy once they click on your ad. The number four powerful tip is you need to review your AdWords, and I'll give some hints on how to do this. This is a thing that a lot of people forget to do, which just blows my mind. It's such a waste. If you're spending the money on the data and you're not reviewing the data, you're once again wasting your money. And finally, number five, set up shopping ads. Google shopping ads, also known as product listing ads, are extremely profitable. I know so many people that are using these with success that it blows my mind when I find that someone is not doing it. I just was off a consulting call earlier today, and the guy was having success with regular text ads, but had not yet implemented Google shopping ads. And I guarantee when he does, all the money he's making off text ads, he's gonna make that plus maybe another, like make double that using product listing ads. And then at the end of this video, I do have a bonus tip for anybody that is willing to stay the whole length through the video, and it's worth it because I'm gonna have a lot of good information on each one of these. So let's start with number one, finding proper keywords. And what do I mean by proper keywords? I mean keywords that when people search them, they actually have buying intent, not something that's just generic. So let me give a quick example of this. And if you've seen other of my videos, you've probably seen me use this example, but it's worth repeating right here. The business that I was talking about earlier, the multi-million dollar revenue business, is a dance clothing business. We manufacture and sell dance clothing. And using AdWords, I did a very scientific method on how I was able to make them profitable. One of the big things was picking the proper keywords. So I would never bid on the word dance clothing. Why? It's too generic. When someone searches for dance clothing, they're not ready to buy yet. They're just in research mode. A better example would be dance shorts. At least that's someone that's looking for dance shorts. At least they have an idea of what kind of dance clothing item they want. Still not great. Ivory dance shorts, a little bit better because at least they know at this point what color they want. And I would bid on that. That's good enough for now that I would bid on that. But the best case scenario would be ivory high waist dance shorts. Why? Because it's so specific that the only reason someone's gonna be bidding on that, or the only reason someone's gonna be searching that in Google, is if they're ready to buy. And I wanna bid on that keyword. So that's number one, make sure you're picking proper keywords. Number two, find negative keywords. And I have a bunch of different ways on how to do this. In fact, I'll link up a video right up here on how to find negative keywords for your AdWords, but it's hugely important, especially if you're doing broad or phrase match in AdWords. And if you don't know what that is, I'll explain that in a separate video. But if you're doing broad match, which I recommend in the early days, so let's say I was doing high waist, let's say I was doing ivory dance shorts as a broad match. So people could type in ivory dance shorts for hip hop, ivory dance shorts Target, ivory dance shorts Walmart. Like they could type in anything they wanted to and my ad would show up unless I added it as a negative keyword. So let's say I would add Walmart, for instance, as a negative keyword, because if someone's typing in ivory dance shorts Walmart, I don't want my ad to come up because they don't want to buy it from me. They want to buy it from Walmart. So I'm bidding on ivory dance shorts unless someone also adds the negative keyword Walmart. So you want to think through what are all the negative keywords, and there's a bunch of tools that will help you do this. And like I said, I'll link up in this video a way of how to do that. And also in my AdWords success pack, I have some other tools as well on finding negative keywords. So number two, the second powerful tip is negative keywords. Tip number three is write powerful ad copy. Even if you find the perfect keywords and you did all the negative keywords, if your ad copy just stinks, you're not gonna have success. No one's gonna click on your ad. Like for instance, once again, let's use the ivory dance shorts. If I was bidding on the search term ivory dance shorts, but when my ad popped up, it said microwaves, obviously no one's gonna click on my ad because people that are searching for ivory dance shorts aren't gonna click on an ad about microwaves. Now that's an extreme example, but let's bring it home a little bit. If I'm bidding on ivory dance shorts, I want my ad copy to include the word ivory dance shorts because people are searching for ivory dance shorts. They wanna see that in the ad. I'd also do other things though. I'd include words like free shipping maybe, or made in the USA. I would include the benefits and the values that I have. 200 plus colors. Now, anytime you can, you wanna add numbers, like 100% made in the USA. That's great because it catches people's eyes. When they're looking at a screen full of text and there's a number in there, their eyes are naturally attracted to it. So you wanna sell the benefits of your product in there, and then you wanna make it so when people do click on the ad finally, they're brought to a product page that actually corresponds to what you're talking about. You don't wanna bring them to a product page or a category page that has nothing to do with what the ad's about. And I've seen this over and over again. Some of my competitors do this. So you definitely wanna make it as seamless as possible where they can click on your ad and click add to cart and click checkout. Make it as easy as possible. That's why Amazon has the one click checkout option, because they know if people have to do too much work, a certain percentage of them will abandon the cart. Tip number four is review your AdWords. And this is one of the number one reason people fail over and over again with AdWords is they don't ever review them. They set them up once and they let it go. Or even if they do review them, a lot of times people don't review them properly, which is a huge mistake. You gotta actually spend some time and properly review them. So how do you do this? Well, there's a few different steps, and I'll do a video at some point about how to review your AdWords. And obviously there's more information in the course about this, but in short, what you're doing is you're looking at which campaigns, which ad groups are successful, and increasing the bids on those if it makes sense, looking at which ones are maybe neutral and deciding what's wrong with it. Is it the ad copy and fixing the ad copy if necessary? Split testing ad copy, picking the winner of the split test and doing a new split test. Things like turning off anything that's just blatantly unsuccessful and lowering the bids on things, because maybe you spent $100 in AdWords, but you only made $50 profit. Well, then cut the bids by half and at least you'd be break even. And there's benefits too there. Remember, you don't necessarily need to make money off the first sale. You can make money off the second sale or the third sale. And there's something to be said about when you sell an item, you're not always making money on that first sale. Like that person that bought that item might go and tell someone else about it. And so you actually made money on that next sale that they told someone about. We had an example of this. Someone bought one pair of dance shorts from the dance clothing company I was talking about. And then they went and told their studio about it, and we had a $4,000 order within a few weeks. So I might have lost money on that first sale, but I made so much more money off that bigger sale. So you gotta make sure you're seeing the bigger picture, and when you're reviewing your AdWords, there's a process, there's a science to it, but it's also an art. The other part about reviewing your AdWords is finding negative keywords and finding good keywords. Maybe you find keywords you didn't think about before, add new ad groups to them. So that's, I'll leave number four at that, but reviewing your AdWords is hugely important. Number five, set up Google Shopping Ads. These are also known as product listing ads. I'll put up an example of what they look like right here. Hugely powerful. And the reason they're so powerful is it shows an image of the item, it shows a price underneath it, and people know when they click on it, they can purchase that thing. That's awesome. With text ads, a lot of times people click on it because they want more information. Because on Google, what do you go to Google for? You go to Google for information. But with Google Shopping Ads, you might just click on it because, if you're clicking on a Google Shopping Ad, it's because you're ready to shop. So hugely important. And a lot of times these are the things that show up at the top of the Google search results. And there's a reason they show up at the top of the Google search results is they're the most profitable for Google. And the reason they're the most profitable for Google is they're the most profitable for people paying for them, like me, the e-commerce entrepreneurs. So if you haven't set these up yet, you're crazy. Definitely set them up. And it's not always easy to make them profitable right away, but you can do it. It just, the big thing with these is you want to add a ton of negative keywords, because Google decides when to show your ads and when not to show your ad. So my product listing ads have somewhere around 5,000 negative keywords. You don't need to start with that much, but you should start with probably 500 to 1,000. And I'll show you, you can get my checklist, the AdWords Success Pack checklist has some tools for finding negative keywords, and so does the course. And I might even do a video at some point about that. I probably have one, and if I do, I'll link it up here. But as promised, I do have a bonus powerful tip for you. The last tip I have for you, and this is the bonus one, is retarget people using display ads. Retargeting and like remarketing ads are some of the best money you can spend. They've already been to your website once, they've already shown interest, you might as well like follow them everywhere. And with one of my, I'm not gonna name the name of it, but with one of my websites, if you go to it, my ads will follow you everywhere. And the reason I'm not gonna name it is I don't want you clicking on my ads. So please don't click on my ads. But anyways, I've had people over and over again go to this website and afterwards they say, everywhere I go now, I see your advertising, which is great for me. Because if a dance mom goes to the website and all of a sudden the ads are following her everywhere, she's more likely to come back and purchase. Remember, they say in psychology, it takes you 7 times of seeing a company before you feel comfortable enough to purchase. Remarket to people. You've already paid for them to come there once, pay for them to come again. It's some of the best money you can spend. So that's the 5 powerful tips, and I'll just rehash them one more time. Number one, find buy intent keywords. Find the proper keywords that are actually worth your money. Number two, find your negative keywords and make sure you add negative keywords. If you don't do this step, you're literally just wasting money. Number three, set up really good high quality ad copy. And I do have some in both the course and in the free checklist, I do have some examples of how to write good ad copy. Number four, review your AdWords. And finally, number five, set up Google Shopping Ads. Once again, there is a checklist for setting up Google Shopping Ads in the AdWords Success Pack up here. And as I mentioned, I have a ton of free videos on how to set up AdWords, but if you're looking for the fastest way to set it up and be successful with it, I did put together all the knowledge into a course. You can check out the AdWords course up here. Highly recommend it. This is something, if I wish I would have known that online courses existed when I was doing AdWords. I spent months and months struggling, and so I'm trying to get rid of that pain period. So if you want the accelerator version, you can click up here to get my AdWords and Google Shopping course. I put all the knowledge, it's a complete brain dump of everything I know about AdWords and Google Shopping, including some behind the scenes footage of my own personal websites. In fact, From scratch, I'm setting up AdWords on my newest company, Performance Nut Butter, and I'm gonna show you that entire process. Like, I'm not gonna hide any of the information, and I show you how I review product listing ads and regular AdWords in that course. If you're not ready for that yet and you just wanna get the free AdWords Success Pack, you can click up here. It includes checklists for setting up AdWords, checklist for reviewing your ads, all that fun stuff. Click up there to get that. There's also gonna be links down below to the course and to the AdWords Success Pack. Last but not least, subscribe and leave a comment down below if you have any questions. So subscribe to get more videos like this. And if you have any questions, I answer every single one. You can leave it down below. Thank you so much for watching this video.